To be an SAS doctor, there are a lot of advantages. First of all, you've got a good family life. Your work-life balance is great. Most interesting part of being a doctor is your clinical attachment, clinical skills, you know, dealing with the patients. And a lot of doctors don't enjoy the management part of it. As an SAS doctor, this takes you away from management and you can concentrate on the best part, what you enjoy most. Just to give you a little quote of our past BMA chair, and he quoted that a few years ago, that SAS doctors, in spite of their Herculean effort and the work they do for NHS, is often marginalized and they are not valued for the work they do for NHS. So this was the quote from the chairman of the BMA council. Mm-hmm. And biggest thing about SAS doctors is they don't get a job plan in which they are recognized. They can't work to the competencies they are skilled to. In appraisal and revalidation, which is a must for everybody, SAS doctors should be supported in that and should be asked to engage in this, because this is part of a GMC requirement. They have to do it. So these are the main challenges which face SAS doctors these days. Professional development should not only be for trainees, it should be not only restricted to trainees, it should be for all group of doctors. SAS doctors may want to become managers and leaders. They should be given an opportunity for that. And similarly, for appraisal and revalidation, they should be encouraged to engage in it. So I think there are a lot of opportunities for SAS doctors if they want to take it. And, you know, they are quite sort of, they can apply for managerial posts, leadership posts, they can become tutors, they can become associate dean, they can take part in teaching of the students. So things are available which previously weren't there. So I think if SAS doctors want, if they don't want to go through the CESAR route, there are other opportunities for them to take. I think in every job, every career post, there are barriers, but one has to overcome these barriers. We have achieved a lot, and opportunities are there for them to be taken. You know, yes, there should be a commitment of the deanery and the professional bodies to support SAS doctors, but I think what matters basically is your commitment as an SAS doctor, and one has to be proactive, and you have to go and take it. Opportunities are there to be taken. In the last 5-10 years, there's been a lot of achievement that has been done. Previously, SAS doctors were not recognized. Now they are recognized. They had a new contract in 2008. Wasn't the perfect contract, but I think it still managed to achieve a lot of things. SAS doctors now represent in various committees. You know, BMA, they are quite upfront. They are in the GMC, Medical Education England, local negotiating committee, locally. So they are representing in all other formats. And the voice of the doctors is being heard. Previously, there was no such route for SAS doctors to progress forward. Now, if SAS doctors want to move forward, CESAR, which was an option for them to progress forward and get onto the specialist registration. What advice I'll give to a new SAS doctor joining the hospital is that if you have taken this as a career choice, you should still be able to develop yourself. There are barriers that may come across to you, which you will easily overcome, provided you are proactive, prepared to learn, prepared to listen to your seniors, and try and do what is expected of you, and make the most of your training that you get as you go along.